Hey, what's up, guys? So welcome to the explanation video for my latest song, Scylla Postscript. Even though that song had absolutely little lyrics in it, like the only lyrics, I'll explain like the part of the song where somebody is talking and stuff. But yeah, pretty much like for my part, there would have been some lyrics, but I was just like, oh no, the song sounds good already. It's just like adding more to it. I feel like that'd just be doing too much. So maybe I might like do a part two to that song and then have what I have to say at the end of it and things. But yeah, stay tuned for that. So anyways, explaining that song. So the song is for a friend of mine's, and the title is even named after her and stuff, Scylla Postscript. So Scylla is a part of her name, and then Postscript is like the initials, because I'm pretty sure everybody, when you writing down a letter and you put like PS, blah, blah, blah and stuff, that PS part, that's for those that don't know, that's what Postscript means, okay? It's because it's like, it was surprised me too when I found out the meaning of it. I was like, oh, that's what it is. After 22 years of living, I just found out what PS stood for and stuff. So, yeah, I was like that. I'm like, nah, I didn't really know what I was going to title it. I was just like, okay, maybe I should title it like Postscript, or maybe I should title it Scylla. But I was just like, nah, let me just tie it all together and just give it like two titles and stuff. So anyways, yeah, that's how the title came about. The song itself. I sampled XXXTentacion's song Skin because I was inspired by his song Guardian Angel, and I was like, okay, next song that I do, or next like sound of music that I do and things, I have to be inspired like by his music and things. So I was like, yeah, I was pretty inspired by it, and his song Guardian Angel, that's like one of my favorite songs off of his last album Skins. But yeah, I sampled his song Skin. Skin and Skins are two different things. You could go on SoundCloud and find his song Skin, and so and then like listen to it and things, and maybe you can hear it. But yeah, I reversed the ending, and then I kind of like stretched it out a little bit so it can have like a slower effect and things, so it can also like fit in with the drums I was gonna add to it and stuff. And yeah, that's how that came about and things. And so yeah, I was like, I liked it. I liked how it overall sounded. First, I was just all like, dang, it doesn't really sound like it fit. But then when I like listened to it, and I was just like, oh, this is amazing. Like this sounds amazing and things. And so yeah, I like chopped up and like kind of edited the little ending part to his song Skin, and then yeah, just let it just like went on from there and things. And so then the little lyrics, I wouldn't really say lyrics, it was more so as a speech within the song that was from a TV show I've never watched a day before in my life, but I think I'm gonna have to watch that show, because I'm like, if dude's saying stuff like that, then it must be a good show. But How I Met Your Mother, have not seen one episode from that show and things. I might have watched some bloopers. I don't know. I don't ever recall watching that show before. So, and the dude's name is Ted Mosby. So I'm like, the fact that I said like that, to me, I felt like that it was destined for me to find that, because I'm like, I felt like that I wanted to say something along those lines, like what he said. I wanted to say something along those lines, but I was just like, I couldn't think of anything to say and stuff. And so I was just like, but I know I wanted to say something meaningful. And so it's always best to like, you know, look out for stuff, you know, for like some like, I don't know, advice or something to inspire me and things. And I found that and was just all like, okay, this, yeah, this is perfect. This is perfect and things. And so I was going to add like something to where I wanted to say, but still couldn't think of any things and stuff. So, and I was just like, I felt like I've, something that I would have said at the end is something that I've already had told my friend and stuff. So I was just all like, yeah, it was, I couldn't think of anything new, at least. I probably would have just, yeah, thought of something old and stuff. But anyways, yeah, and then, from there, it was just like, and then, no, the, like, the gifts that was playing out, because I was like, you know, just explaining the song, but I didn't even explain the video. So the gifts that was playing out, notice how everything, like, took place at night, and it was in the city. That's honestly my favorite scenery. It's, like, stuff at night, like, cities at night. I love how downtown Seattle looks at night. I mean, it wasn't downtown Seattle, it was just a bunch of random places downtown, but I don't know why, but I just love, like, the lights and how everything looks outside, like, at nighttime and stuff. So that's why I did that. And yeah, it was like I had to have like a little bit of like me within that song. But overall, that song was for my friend. But I was like, I had to add a little bit of me in there and stuff. So anyways, yeah, Silla Postscript, that's probably my most creative song ever. And I really do like that's I love that song. Like that song is the best song ever. Like to me, at least, you know, maybe the other people, that might not be their favorite song. But to me, like, yeah, that's my like that's my favorite song that I've ever created and stuff. And so I was going to, because I uploaded it onto SoundCloud, and I was going to have a cover art of it and stuff, but I was just like, nah, that's just, you know, it's, I can't remember what the cover art was and things of it, but I was just like, I did have an original cover art for it, but I deleted it. I just threw it all out, because I was just like, nah, I don't like it. I'm like, it seems like the cover art to it, so it's supposed to be me and this friend, like, standing, but our faces was blurred out, and so I was like, yeah, I was just like, nah, it's, I'll pass on that one. I don't even know what the cover art is to it, because it's like I don't even check SoundCloud and stuff, and it's been a while since I last time I think I was on there was, yeah, when I posted that song. So other than that, I only go on there to like listen to old X and Ski Mask songs. But anyways, yeah, that song, that's probably my all-time favorite song. She said she liked it too and things. She said she was listening to it and stuff, and so yeah, she said she liked it. But anyways, yeah, that is explaining that song and things. Hopefully in the future I can do more songs like that. But anyways, yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. Make sure you guys go check out my latest song, Silla Postscript. It is available on YouTube and SoundCloud. I am thinking about putting it on like other streaming platforms like Spotify and all that stuff. I might just put it on Spotify. But then I'm like, if people start asking to put it like on Apple Music and iTunes and all that stuff, so you can like purchase it, listen to it and stuff, then yeah, I'll most likely do that too. But anyways, yeah, talk to you guys later. Thank you guys for watching. Like, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and peace.